Just to kind of put this into perspective, we are on a new quarterly schedule. The last time we gave you this update was in July, and it did contain April and May. So this will be a condensed version tonight because June statistically is the only change. We are, however, including some just recent activity just for your information. We've had quite a bit of news in the media the last 6 months. Elements International made the newspaper, as well as Texas Real Estate Business News, which is a statewide publication. We've had national and regional media announcement of the Verde development, which has really gotten us quite a bit of inquiries for other activity. The downtown made Channel 5 News. Beverly was interviewed. And so the Front Street infrastructure and business development plans got the city-led efforts some attention there. And so it's really been good to see so much positive news in the media for Mesquite. At a glance, the only real change here is that one more show was attended. You'll see their June Biz Now, a data center investment conference with about 15 prospects visited. And while these are just numbers, they don't really tell you exactly what has come from them. This is a baseline for us to track. And so as we continue these quarterly reports over the years, we're going to show you comparisons and resulting development that comes from these. We cover in our quarterly reports each of your strategic priorities in the area of job creation. Of course, last time we did update you that we had the Turbo Booster Workforce event, so no real change there. There's a new stat on this page that shows you we have 3.6% unemployment rate compared to 4% in Texas for this quarter. That has made the workforce very competitive for Mesquite employers. In the area of retail vitality, this quarter brought us several major developments that are out there for new opportunities, including Sears Gander Mountain is a continuation, has been on the market for a while, and the Toys R Us building. The rent range has not changed since the last report, $10 to $35, and again, we will be tracking this as we continue these quarterly reports. Sales tax was remaining flat as projected and stable. Of course, you saw this month we did have a 4% plus increase. And during this quarter, Townie Small did report a 93% occupancy rate. The BRE has had quite a bit more information since the last quarterly report. We let you know we were planning a fall event. It is now set for November the 13th from 3 to 7. It'll be a four-hour workshop in downtown Mesquite. We've secured a featured keynote speaker named Monty Anderson. He's with Options Real Estate, and he's a pretty well-known South Dallas developer. So he'll be our featured entrepreneurial speaker. The sessions will cover how the Small Business Administration outlines small business development. We'll have sessions on planning, starting, managing, and growing your business. We'll be inviting people to attend. There will be a $20 fee to attend the event. It will include refreshments, and it will be limited to 100 attendees. Also, during this third fiscal year quarter, we had our third year Small Business Week video. You can see the businesses that we covered listed there. And I'm happy to say that several of these businesses have the video shared on their homepage of their website. In the area of shopping center revitalization, we've had some development since our last update. Staff has assembled a list of 26 centers that are identified and given them preliminary rankings in preparation for bringing them to you in the coming months. We have 8 of these centers in active discussions with developers right now. To the right there, you'll see an example of a before and after, one of the developers that we've been talking to that's working in other areas of Dallas. And so that's just a sample of kind of what can become of a facade change. And so working with staff right now with the special projects director, we're working on some policy formation for incentives to redevelop these centers, and we'll be bringing those to you shortly as well. I-20 corridor in the third quarter had the announcement of a new logo, Trinity Point Mesquite, and of course, as you are all well aware, that PIDs and TERSs are being solidified and firmed up, and so economic development is gearing up to marketing these over 1,500 new home lots. This critical mass will help us market for commercial development in the coming year. recently, outside of this quarter, but in the last month, we have seen people coming into our pre-application meetings for High Country Estates and the Connells-Bradley tract as well. In the area of downtown redevelopment, the Main Street application has been submitted. The announcement will be made at the November Texas Downtown Association Conference. The infrastructure plan, of course, made the news. All four-point committees have been appointed under the Main Street program. They're volunteer committees. And we have 9 prospects in discussion right now for downtown redevelopment. And the facade grant process will also be brought to you soon for your input. Economic data has not changed much since the last quarterly report. I will say that in the area of economic development data, we're tracking it by calendar year. So we're at 50% of the year at the onset of this report. This economic development data has not changed since we last met either major employers. This is where we're really tracking. If you'll notice, commercial remodel permits, we're at 50% of the year. We're well over 50% in the area of permits, and you can see down below that permit valuation is well over 50% of last year. A lot of that is due to the school remodels. In the area of new construction permits, we're slightly under 50%, but still tracking very strong for this year compared to last year and certainly compared to 2016. Further data, you'll see sales tax is right at 50% for the year, and new jobs and square footage are down a little bit because the way we track this is when a permit is pulled. So Ashley would have been pulled in 2017, which skews it a little bit when you have an 877,000 square foot building. Certificates of occupancy are right under 50% compared to last year as well. New things in the future of economic development department is our marketing. We've really been aggressively strategizing for a full implementation in 2019 of a marketing website, which will basically market, call to action, and be a website we push to developers to ask for investment in Mesquite. So that's under construction and should go live in spring of 19. We have a trade show booth RFP that's come back to us, so we'll be designing a booth that will be interchangeable across departments where we can change out the panels, marketing can use it, parks could use it, airport can use it, whoever needs to, with the simple switch out of graphics. We're in the middle of a business recruitment video. We're working with the same company as the CVB. And you'll see that we are running more ads in various publications down there in the lower right corner. That was recently in Texas Real Estate Business News, of course, bragging about the Ashley construction. And this just in, KEOM featured Mayor Pickett and our director, David Witcher, last week. Thanks to marketing and communications setting that up. The Marriott Town Place did celebrate their grand opening. And Iron Horse Village concepts have been announced and have also made the press. So with that, I'll entertain any questions that you have.
Thank you very much. Great update. Questions?
10 minutes flat, Mayor.
You did.
Can you go back to page 13 or slide 13?
Please? Absolutely.
On the right-hand side there, all of those COs, so those, when can we expect all of those to be open and operating? Are they all open and operating?
The ones that are listed are open and operating during the third quarter.
Okay. And one of the things that we had heard about and had been featured was the porch swing. Had gotten a few questions about when they might be opening.
They are saying October 1st.
Okay.
At this time.
Thank you. Good work.
Thank you. Good. The Texas Baptist Men, I'm glad you pointed out this slide because I wanted to point out they built their Texas headquarters here. It's a brand new building.
That's great. So there's a question on Mr. Blackwell's Cafe.
Oh, yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. I'm just curious where it is. I hadn't heard of it before.
It's on Gus Thomason, north of 30. And I was informed by Mr. McCullough with the Mesquite Chamber of Commerce. He did a business retention visit there. It's a 600 square foot cafe, and he said you have got to try it. He said it's dynamite.
It's
so, pardon me.
Got it. So it's on the Brahms up there before you get to La Prada.
Got it. Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That will go good with La Unión Panadería. Where is that going to be at?
Which one, sir?
La Unión Panadería.
The last one on that slide.
I would have to check the address on that one. I will be happy to get that for you.
He doesn't.
I'll have to check that one. Anything else?
Good job on the translation, Councilman O'Shea.
That's right. All right. Very good.